Hi, hello, good evening everyone. Welcome back to this Economy Booster Sessions for just 10 minutes daily. This is Nisha Nujamuthi, your EduCare Academy. So today in the so-called Booster Sessions of Economy, we have another interesting trending economy topic, which is none other than Longitudinal Aging Study of India. So now this is a particular study which was conducted in our country, India, with regard to the elderly population. So let's quickly have a look into what is the so-called topic all about. And this is indeed one of the most important, current affairs topic as well. So apart from that, guys, if you see the description box of this particular video, you can see the schedule of my free class and plus class, which happens at 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. daily, and also which happens at 8 a.m. 10 a.m. daily. You can just go through all those. So now, talking about the Longitudinal Aging Study of India, recently the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, okay, they are the one who released this report in the context of wave one on the virtual or online platform. So don't you think so? Out of all the populations, even the elderly or let's say the aged population is also quite important. So taking into consideration that particular scenario only, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has literally released this particular report called as Longitudinal Aging Study of India. Now, if you have a look with regard to the elder, the population of elders in our country, India, as per the International Institute of Population Sciences, it is said that the people who are 60 plus, who are the senior citizens, the ratio is let's say 8.6%, which means that out of 1.21 billion population, as per the 2011 census, around 103.84 million guys, take care, those many people, they are all senior citizens who are 60 plus. Whereas if you see, another important estimate by the same International Institute of Population Sciences, they shows that by the year 2050, okay, an estimated 600 million out of 1.7 billion Indians will be in the age of pre-retirement or let's say older, which means they'll be either 45 or 45 plus. So these are the two important data that was figured out by the so-called International Institute, guys, with regard to elderly population. So don't you think so? It's quite important to have a study regarding the current situation or scenario of our country, India's elderly population. Yes, it is indeed very important. That is why the so-called report study was put forward. Now, what is this study all about is very simple. It is a full-scale national survey wherein they'll have a very proper scientific investigation with regard to the health, economic and social determinants and what are the factors or the consequences of the so-called population aging with regard to country, India. And when did we have the so-called, study, guys? It was commissioned since 2016. And I can tell you that as far as the country India is concerned, it is the very first and indeed the world's largest ever survey, which provides a longitudinal database through which you'll be able to design policies and programs for the elder or let's say the older population in so many broad domains. What are the economic, what are the social needs that they need? What about the health perspective? What about the economic well-being? In various factors or let's say perspective, we'll be able to design policies to help our elderly or let's say older population. That is why the so-called Longitudinal Aging Study of India was conducted. In short form, it is called as LASI. Not your drinking wala LASI, okay? This is a short form of this. Anyways, now, who are the agencies involved in the so-called Longitudinal Study? If you see, the National Program for Healthcare of Elderly, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, they are the ones who undertook the so-called Longitudinal Aging Study of India. And they took the help of even the IIPS, that is International Institute of Population, for Population Sciences, which is put up in Mumbai in association with, again, the Harvard School of Public Health, then another university in USA called as Southern California University, then the United Nations Population Fund, and also the National Institute on Aging. So many organizations are part of the so-called Longitudinal Aging Study Survey of our country, India. Now, this itself makes you understand that it is India's very first and the world's largest ever longitudinal survey because it consists of the works of so many agencies. And what about the coverage of this particular study? Now, the first national wave of the so-called LASI, or let's say the wave one, it covered a baseline sample of 72,000 individuals who are 45 years and above, I can say. And also their spouses, including people who are elderly, people who are 60 plus as well. And also some in some of the surveys, if you see, there were people who are 75 plus from across all the states and UTs. And now here, one important thing to note is that, excluding Sikkim, every other states and UTs were taken into consideration. That is also another important point. The coverage was not coming for the so-called northeastern state, that is Sikkim. And what is the methodology? They use a lot of detailed data based on health, and then the biomarkers together with all the information based on family and social network, the income of the people, the assets and so-called consumptions and all. They collect all these things together. and then they put across the analysis estimates based on the so-called longitudinal aging study of India. And if you see, as per the findings with regard to the so-called longitudinal aging study, in the 2011 census, I can tell you that 60 plus population, they accounted for 8.6% of our country, India's population. That's what I told you initially also, accounting for 103 million elderly population out of 1.2 billion population for our country, India. So every year or annually, let's say they're growing at the rate of 3%. And the number of elderly people, if this is the ratio, means definitely it will increase to, let's say, 319 million in the years to come, approximately in the year 2050. And though that is the case also, the kind of medical facilities that is available for the elderly people is not up to mark. That is why if you see, 75% of elderly people in our country, India, they suffer from one or some other kind of chronic or long-term disease. Whereas 40% of elderly people, if you see, who are 60 or 60 plus, they'll have some or the other disability. And some another 20%, if you see, if they're not physically having any issues or any other chronic disease, then they'll be having issues based on their mental health. So these are the kind of issues that they're facing. So don't you think so? It's high time that we have to provide a great support to them? Yes, it is indeed important. And also with regard to the cardiovascular or the heart diseases, the self-reported prevalence of that is again 28% among all the older adults who are 45 plus. This doesn't mean that for the cardiovascular disease, they should be 60 plus. Even once they cross the age of 40, they're not old. But then they're just entering the old age, right? We cannot say somebody who's 45 or let's say 45 plus is an older population compared to 60 or 60 plus. But in that time itself, they're getting all these kind of diseases. And if you see the prevalence of multi-morbidity conditions among the elderly populations who are 60 years and above, that is very much higher in the few states and UTs, especially in Kerala, which is 52, followed by Chandigarh, then Lakshadweep, Goa, and the UT Andaman Nicobar Islands. So now the prevalence of such single morbidity and the multi-morbidity conditions, I can tell you, it keep on increasing with age. Here, if you see the state of Kerala, they are known for elderly population. When you talk about the demographic dividend for our country, India, the number of young working population, we know that the southern side, or let's say south part of our country, has an elderly population, whereas the northern part of our country, India, they have a lot of young population. And which means that the southern side should literally have a better medical facilities as such. And that is the reason why, the population is higher there, the elderly population. But still, if you see the multi-morbidity conditions among the elderly who are 60 and 60 plus, it is quite high in the states of Kerala as such. So that is indeed a valid point to be noted. And what is the importance of such kind of study? Very simple. Whatever data you get with regard to the so-called longitudinal aging study, you can use that them to further strengthen and broaden the scope of national program for healthcare of elderly people. So you'll be able to establish a range of preventive and also healthcare programs for all these older and elderly population and make sure that they are getting protected. And the so-called COVID-19 pandemic, this particular study with regard to the aging population makes a lot of sense because they are the people with lack of immunity and they are in the elderly category. So it is the chances of them getting infected is more high. So then preventing them or let's say protecting them from such kind of thing is indeed very important. So that is one such point to be noted. Now, if you see, there is another program called as National Program for Health Care of Elderly. And that is actually implemented under the NCD, non-communicable disease, like your diabetes, your BP, your cholesterol, all these things are coming under NCDs. So they come under under them, and which comes under the so-called umbrella of the National Health Mission for districts and below in the states. Again, very simple, to create new architecture for aging is one of the mission to make sure that there is a proper accessibility, affordability and high quality, long-term, comprehensive and dedicated care services which has been offered to the older elderly population. For that particular purpose, only such kind of national level program for the healthcare of elderly has been put forward by the government. Clear? And also to make sure that we are promoting the concept of active and healthy aging. That is, when you get older, it shouldn't be like you're weak, you're brittle, your bones are brittle and you should be lying on the bed. No, rather, you should have a kind of aging factor with regard to the concept of being active and healthy, free from all the diseases. That is the whole point of such kind of longitudinal aging study with regard to our country, India. So this is what you should know with regard to this particular topic. And also a few of the important data with regard to the so-called topic are as follows. If you see, all the elderly people who are 60 years and above in our country are eligible beneficiaries of various schemes put forward by the government under the National Healthcare for the Elderly People. And this is a centrally sponsored scheme, I can tell you, because 75% of the total budget has been borne by the central government, whereas the remaining 25% has been done by the state government. Clear? have free specialized healthcare facilities exclusively for the elderly population has been done through proper state health delivery system under the so-called mission. So thank you so much, Manga officers. If you do like this video, don't forget to like, share and put your valuable feedbacks in the comment box. So what do you think? Such kind of longitudinal report with regard to our aging population for our country, India, is very important, right? So do put your feedbacks in the comment box. Thank you and stay tuned tomorrow at the same time, 8 p.m. to 8:10 p.m. with another interesting topic. And with regard to Unacademy Plus program and free program, use the code NishaIASLIFE to get a discount of 10% from the Plus subscription, also to get an access to the free live class of mine at 6 p.m. Thank you and Jai Hind.